I'm Dan McMillan for Orland Park TV, and we've got a very special segment today. We're here at one of Orland's finest, if not the finest, events of the year, the Taste of Orland Park. And directly to my left is probably the finest restaurateur, definitely the top craft brewer in the state of Illinois and here in Orland Park, the proprietor, we'll call him the proprietor, of Granite City here in Orland Park. As we make our way through Taste of Orland Park, we said this is the first place that we have to stop at because it's the most important. It has the best beer and the best food. So, Jason Adamchek, did I say it right?
You did.
Jason?
I butchered it this time.
I didn't do it. Welcome. Well, great to see you. We're here. Who do you have as your partner at your side here?
Maricel Stanfield.
Hello.
Maricel, you've been working with Mr. Adamchek for about 22 years, and does it wear thin, or is every day just a great day here at Granite City?
Every day is a great day at Granite City, of course.
I'm the reason she's got gray hair.
Yes.
That is true. Yeah.
Yes, yes. He's given a few gray hairs in his time, but that's what it takes to run a brewery, a world-class brewery. That's what we'll call best-in-class, world-class brewery. We're here, though, today. We did a show a few months ago. It had our highest ratings of the year and probably the best reception. We did a show at Granite City, and it was and I did a little cooking. Was that I think I made the was that the pot? What was that?
Chicken asparagus linguine.
So we made that. We're here at the Taste. What are we serving at the Taste this year?
This year we have the prime rib sandwich, and then we also have our barbecue pulled pork, yeah, along with one of our signature appetizers, our spinach and artichoke dip.
Now, each of those, can you get each of those at the restaurant also?
Everything besides the pulled pork. The pulled pork we used to have on the menu, then we bring it back as a special every now and again. We do have it on one of our burgers, the Big Show Burger.
Big Show Burger.
Mm-hmm. What's that called?
It's the Big Show Burger. It's pretty much a burger with cheddar cheese, barbecue sauce, pulled pork, and onion strings.
Whoa, I'm going to have to come in and get one of those. What did you call it, the Big Show?
Yeah.
Folks, it's the Big Show here at Granite City. So we're here at the Granite City. It's the third day. We're here on, so it gives you an idea. It's sunny. It's a beautiful, sunny Sunday afternoon. We're over here in Taste. We got music in the background. What's your thoughts on this year's 2015? Taste and how it's went, and how do you expect to wrap it up?
It's been going great this year. I think last year we had rain on Friday, so it kind of dampened the mood, but I think this year has been fantastic. Our second year doing it this year, so we're a little bit more organized, kind of know what to expect, what we need to plan for. We have plenty of great staff on today. Everybody's having a good time. Everybody knows it gets you out of the restaurant. Yeah, you're working, but it's fun. It's a different environment. I think it just brings like just a laid-back, fun environment.
I've heard that everyone at the restaurant loves working with you so much that you actually have to hold a lottery to get to these guys to be able to work with you here at the Taste. Maricel, is that true?
So true.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you won the lottery to be here.
Oh yes, I was very lucky to do that.
You mean I was bribed for them to come out here?
Takes a little bribing, a little lottery.
Marvin over there, Marvin, he likes to come out here.
Marvin loves being out here. Marvin, how are you today? Are you the chef?
I am not. But I am today.
You are today. He's the chef of the day, but he does, folks, go to Granite City, ask, of course, for Mr. Adamchek as the proprietor, but Marvin will make sure Marvin will be cooking up something special for you.
He actually might be serving you. He's one of the servers there too as well.
Oh, he can do it all. He can do it from the front to the back.
He manages everything. Yeah, he's probably right about that. But he manages too and stuff, so yeah, he does a great job sometimes.
Is he the MVP of Granite City?
Ask him.
Okay. So
just ask him right there on camera.
Folks, let's we're gonna confirm it right here first. Marvin is the MVP of Granite City. So when you come on in to Granite City, let's just say hello one time to Marvin. Marvin, how are you?
I'm doing pretty good. How you doing?
Okay, how long you been with Granite City?
About a year and a half, I think.
You making your mark?
Trying to.
Okay, well, we're going to be looking for you next year here, of course, but we'll be stopping into the restaurant to see you.
All right, I'll be there.
Okay, so that's Marvin, the MVP of MVP of Granite City. So as we enjoy the festivities here at the Taste, any crazy customers? Did you had anything go where you guys had to actually? Did you have to take anybody down or do anything, or just calm somebody down that didn't quite understand what a craft beer is?
No, nothing like that yet. No, not yet. Days early though; it's just starting. So.
Yes, the crowd's been cooperative.
So far, so good. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
What do you think your chances are in the to win the booth of the year?
That one I don't know. There's a lot of great looking booths out here, actually. So they're pretty fantastic. So everybody put a lot of work into them this year.
They really did. You guys are one that I think you're in the running. You're in the running. We did the judging yesterday, and it'll be announced later today, I think, after.
Angela's idea, right there.
I think, Angela, you did a phenomenal job. Keep up the good work. I'm sorry you didn't get MVP. But Marvin had to take that honor this year. But you did a phenomenal job. I've heard that is your sign. So you created the sign, folks. You see the sign back here, Granite City. When that lights up at night, you can see that sign for miles. They're O'Hare Airport's going to use that sign after the Taste to land planes. So they're looking forward to it. A post Taste, that sign will be in the O'Hare right on the runway. So we're looking forward to it. It's going to be great. You guys will probably get an award from corporate for having something that's actually going to be. What better publicity could you get than being at O'Hare Airport? So great job. Great job. Now, tonight I heard, for the entertainment that we're having, the Beatles are playing. So it's
Marvin sings, too. Right?
Marvin sings? What is one of his favorite songs?
He likes Stevie Wonder.
Okay. My Sharia Moore? I should break into it right now, but I'll hold off. Little Stevie Wonder.
American English tonight, yes.
Yeah, American English tonight. Then I've heard a rumor flowing through that, American English being a Beatles band, then with Paul McCartney's in town this weekend. I've heard from good sources that Paul McCartney's going to show up and sing here tonight on the stage. What do you think the chances are of that happening?
It's a same amount of chances of us winning the tent, the best decoration.
Well, I think you got a good chance. And okay, so Paul McCartney will be here later. Hopefully, I heard he loves craft beer, so Paul McCartney comes up here. Paul McCartney comes up and asks for a brew. You know, he's from London, I hear, Liverpool, and
yes.
So what would you suggest? What would you serve him if he asked for your finest beer?
I would have to go with the Batch 1000, the double IPA.
Batch 1000 double IPA. So that's in the brewery lingo. Batch 1000 double IPA. What's a double IPA versus a single IPA?
Well, you're gonna do double the hops on that bad boy.
Oh,
so absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, so this is inside lingo that we're getting here, folks. So you normally don't get on any other TV show. We're figuring out how to brew.
Wikipedia, maybe.
You'd have to go on Wikipedia, and we know how hard that is to do. So we're just bringing it to you right here on Orland Park TV. So we're looking forward a little later. Paul McCartney coming by for a craft brew, and we are looking forward to a real big day. It's going to be a wonderful day, wonderful night. Can you? Pardon me?
He's going to give us the award for the tent.
Yes. Paul McCartney is here. That's the other rumor that's flowing around. He is going to bring out the award for Tent of the Year. Now, being objective, if you were not voting for yourself for Tent of the Year here at the Taste, who would you vote for Tent of the Year?
To be honest with you, I mean, I came here Thursday when everybody was kind of setting up, and I'll tell you what, Beggars, they pretty much tore their tent down and redid it with their front of their decorating, and they got the nice pizza oven on the side there. They did a rocking out job. Rocco Vino's has got a nice little setup over there.
Yes, he does.
You know, Cooper's Hawk actually didn't look too bad either.
Cooper's Hawk's very classy. Now, they're I like that because they're the wine, you're the beer. They're the wine and beer. So you guys set off each other nicely. And you know who also has a very nice one, and we're going to go visit them a little later, is Banana Bliss. Have you seen theirs?
She did. I didn't get there yet. I'm sorry.
Banana Bliss, folks. I think you need to visit Banana Bliss. If you're ready for a very good meal here in Orland Park, and you're not going to Granite City because you've been there too many times in a week, because everyone has to go there at least once a week. If you've already been there this week and you don't want to go there three times in 1 week, you should go to visit Banana Bliss, because they have a phenomenal menu that people just don't know enough about. So many times when you hear Banana Bliss, the first thing you think of is that's a smoothie place. Did you think that before?
I did. I thought it was a smoothie place.
Yeah, I always did too. And then we went in there about a month ago and did a little show and found out how really diverse their menu is. And so I don't think people understand how diverse sometimes Granite City menu might be. And you have to keep telling people, because it's a brewery, but it's got such a diverse menu. And let me just give me your dish of the month here at Granite City that's coming up in August. You got something if we come up, if I can only go there one time this month, and I'm going to be there at least 22 times, but if I can only go there one time, what dish am I going to get?
Oh, that's a hard one. We have really good dishes. My personal favorite is the shrimp tacos. They're a little bit spicy, but they're delicious. What do you think?
You cooked yours last time. I mean, the chicken asparagus linguine, I think, is awesome. It's got a lot of that going on in that dish.
Yes, it does.
But again, it's you got the asparagus, just the seasoning on the chicken. The linguine that's in there is awesome. So that or... our burgers are awesome too.
Burgers are phenomenal there, but I like the idea of the shrimp tacos and the linguine. What do we call that dish?
Chicken asparagus linguine.
Chicken asparagus linguine. Just go in there and tell them you want the dish that Dan McMillan made famous by cooking it on TV in Orland Park.
Get there now too, because the road is now open from Mario's construction.
Yes. So folks, we're announcing it here. The road from Mario's construction is now open to which gives you an even better access to Granite City, and I think and hopefully sometime in the near future that whole LaGrange road, that construction in front of you, will be fixed. You'll have you're just going to have such access. Your business will explode. You'll probably have to start opening 24 hours a day just to feed the masses. So what are your thoughts on opening 24 hours a day, because you're probably going to be the one that works the midnight shift?
As long as they build an apartment upstairs, I'm good.
Okay, see, now that's dedication. That's why she won the lottery to be here, because she's dedicated. She's dedicated. So we've talked all about Granite City, all about the taste, all about our MVP Marvin. We're excited about all of this. So we want to just say to sum it up, what is your favorite part? No, you don't get to wander it around, but what do you see as the favorite part of Taste of Orland Park?
I just think it's great for families of all sorts. I mean, couples, families with kids. It's a great weekend to get out, especially when the weather's like this and it's not like humid. It's just perfect weather out here. It's just a great atmosphere. Cars show in the background, music up front over there, food in the middle. And they got a lot of activities for everything. So it's just a great time to come out. I mean, this is your second time being here. So, I mean, I've been here many years before, but.
Yes, it's my second time.
So what are your thoughts on it?
I like it. I think people are having fun. They love our food. They love everyone's food. They get to try a little bit of everything. So.
We've got fun, food, and entertainment.
Yes.
Pretty much sums it up.
Does that sum it up? Okay, folks.
And alcohol.
Oh, alcohol.
Well, we have alcohol.
Is that part of the fun or the entertainment?
That is...
Either one.
Yeah, the more you drink, the more fun and the more entertaining you are. So, hopefully we don't get too much entertainment with the folks out here, but we want a lot of entertainment. We're looking forward to Paul McCartney bringing around the award later on, and then singing with the American English. So it's going to be a wonderful day, and it's been a wonderful weekend here at the Taste of Orland Park. We want to thank Mayor Dan McLaughlin and the trustees for once again putting on one of the finest events in the greater Chicagoland area on an annual basis. So for Orland Park TV, I'm Dan McMillan here at Granite City, in the Granite City booth, one of the finest booths here at the Taste of Orland Park. Paul McCartney will be by later to tell us. I'm here with Jason Adamczyk and
Marisol Stanfield.
Marisol Seinfeld, the real backbone here. But of course, we've got Marvin, and we've got the creator, Angela, the creator of the sign behind us that will soon be at O'Hare Field, bringing in the planes. So, thank you. We'll be right back visiting another wonderful restaurant here at Taste of Orland Park. Thank you. I'm Dan McMillan, and we're back for Orland Park TV, and we're here at the Taste of Orland Park, probably the finest event in Orland Park on an annual basis, and we're showcasing some of the wonderful restaurants that are here, and we're in a booth that is probably definitely the finest Irish restaurant, first of all, I better introduce this gentleman next to me, because he gets a little antsy at times. This is Justin from Square Cal. Justin, thanks for having us today.
Thank you.
It's great to be here. It really is. We saw you a couple of, it's been about probably 5-6 months ago. We were at the restaurant when you first opened up, and we did a little show. Probably the highest ratings and the most popular show we've ever done.
Love it.
Probably because of you. And the word got out, and Orland's most handsome proprietor. So we have the proprietor of the Square Celt here, Justin. And we're here. You've spent the weekend now at the Taste of Orland. Well, give me a few random thoughts on what the taste means to the restaurants, what the taste means to Orland Park.
You know, out of all the festivals that I've done, this is a phenomenal event. I've never seen so much community involvement come throughout the Taste. There's so many little groups and restaurants, and everybody's in a good mood. Everybody's, talking, hanging out. This is probably one of the best festivals I've ever worked in. It's awesome because the community comes out for people that haven't been to Square Cult.
Yeah.
They come and have a little sample, and they're like, oh, we're in love. Let's go to Square Cult.
This is it, and I will tell you, everyone, so everyone watch, and remember, you want to visit the Square Cult as often as possible, not just for St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
That's the big day, but I'm telling you, I've visited it a number of times. They have definitely have the finest Irish menu you'll find in the state of Illinois. Give me a couple of ideas. Well, first of all, let's talk about, what are you serving this weekend here at the Taste?
Today we got over 7 different beers, and we have to have Guinness on tap. I mean, being Irish, you gotta have a little bit of Guinness. Then we have about 5 different food items. We have deep fried Snickers.
Oh.
We have a short rib slider.
Whoa.
We have house smoked brisket tacos. We also have fish and chips. We have to have that. That's one of our classics. And then we also have Parmesan and truffle fries.
Whoa, you are going all out here. So
we don't hold back.
Of all of those items, the Snickers really caught my eye, but the fish and chips and everything on it, is everything you're serving here also available at the restaurant?
Yep, same exact things are at the restaurant.
So I can get a fried Snickers at the restaurant?
Absolutely.
Whoa.
You get one. There would give you two.
Okay, that is always my favorite part of the meal, is the dessert. But of course you'll have Guinness.
Yep.
Guinness is very popular. As you prepared for the Taste. Beautiful booth, and we'll show some of it on the outside. As you got ready to decorate, what went into it, and who came up with all the great ideas?
You know, it was on Thursday, about 8:00 at night. Me and my manager Sam, we were all here. We're like, all right, let's decorate. So we just started throwing, garland up, throwing shamrocks up everywhere, and we didn't know really what our plan was.
Yeah.
We just knew we wanted to change it all. And finally, about 9:00, we're like, let's do the light bulbs. So we changed out all the light bulbs, and then we're done.
This is it. So this is very spontaneous, and I tell you, I do think you're in the running for Booth of the Year, right? Because I was part of the judging yesterday, and you guys are right up there. But then there's a first, second, and third. So
love it.
You definitely could be in the top three, and it's great. It's just another part of the Taste that everyone works, so hard, but it's fun putting together the booths. So how did you guys pick your staff here, your crew from to come? come out was, you know, I'm told that everyone loves to spend so time with you so much that you had to have a lottery so people could win the opportunity to come and work the taste. Was that true?
No, absolutely not. I mean, I'm a nice guy, but I'm not that nice. I wanted to give all my staff a little chance. I know they all want to come out of the restaurant, out here. So I gave everybody a different, you know, shot, whether it's, you know, the day shift or the night shift. Let them come out, have fun for, you know, 4 or 5 hours. And basically, I got the best cooks I got here, so I wanted to blow it out of the water.
Very good. So everyone's here. There, it looks like you've got a phenomenal staff. Everyone's happy to be here. I just wanted to run a rumor by you. I've heard a rumor. Tonight, American English is playing, so it'll be right in front of you. But since, you know, it's a Beatles band.
Yep.
I heard, you know, Paul McCartney's in town. Yep. There's a rumor flowing around here that Paul McCartney's going to be here tonight to play with the Beatles band. What do you think?
You know what? I hope that's true, because if so, then I'll be up on stage with Paul, you know, having a beer with him and hanging out.
Yes, and he's also going to come by, they said, and he's the one who's going to award the prizes for best booth. So he'll be coming around, and then he'll get up on stage and sing, and you guys can get up there and sing with him. And it'll, so that, if that in mind, we're here to taste. Paul McCartney will be here a little later and to help sing with the Beatles. What, and to summarize it all, what does the taste mean for you and for the restaurant and for Orland Park? What, in just in your humble thoughts?
You know, from opening since October, Orland Park has been very generous, very, you know, gracious with opening their doors to us. So this is our way to kind of give back and say, let us help you serve the food, serve the beer for the customers and the community of Orland Park. And this is also another great way to get our name out there, because, you know, no matter what advertising you do, what marketing you do, basically you can't get your name out enough.
No,
this is just another way. So,
never,
you know, on our part, we want to thank Orland Park and the community for letting us be here, because we are brand new.
Yeah.
It gives us a shot to be with restaurants that have been here for many years.
Yeah, no, you're one of 20 restaurants. It's a wonderful event, and everyone loves being out here, whether it's at lunchtime, dinner time, or for a nighttime snack, and the entertainment's been wonderful. And so we look forward to taking this momentum from the taste right on through the rest of the year and on into the holidays. So we're going to be looking forward to seeing you at the restaurant numerous times. So folks, come on out here and see Justin from Orland, from Square Celt. And I say it right now, it took me a while before I remembered to always say Celt, Square Celt. Last question. Since we got the Beatles coming tonight, I always like to know, it's a reflection, I think, of somebody of character. Beatles or Stones?
You know, honestly, I was born in 88. I'm a youngin', so if I were to pick any, it'd be the Stones.
So he's picking the Stones. We won't say that before Paul gets here, because you want to have a chance to get on stage with them, though. Still, but the Stones, and it's not a right answer, but yeah, the Stones have had such influence, so have the Beatles. But I don't know what it is. I got that question from Quentin Tarantino, and that's the way he always said he'd like to end interviews when he did them, was Stones or Beatles, and he'd usually turn it on there when he was being interviewed. But so Stones or Beatles, we have Stones here, folks, and we have Justin from the Square Celt. We want to thank you for having us today. Good luck the rest of the year, and good luck tonight. You're going to have a heck of a night here at the Taste of Orland Park. Thank you very much. We're here, and we want to thank Mayor Dan McLaughlin and the trustees for another wonderful event at the Taste of Orland Park. Yeah. Orland Park. I'm Dan McMillan, and we're back here at the Taste of Orland Park for Orland Park TV. We're here at the Taste of Orland, and it's just been a wonderful, wonderful weekend, a weekend beyond belief. And we're stopping down now to visit with our absolute, the favorite restaurateur of Orland Park, Mr. Brian Sword of 94 West. Brian?
How you doing, Dan?
How are you?
Good, thank you.
It is always a pleasure to see you, always a pleasure to visit with you, whether it's here at the Great Outdoors or it's at your fine restaurant in at 94 West on 94th Avenue. Now, we're here at the Taste of Orland. How many years you've been coming here to Taste of Orland?
I think 10 years.
Yeah. Are you one of the founders?
I am the first.
You're the first. You were here at the beginning.
Yes, I was.
Okay, so now, how have you seen the festival evolve?
I've seen more kids come out with their parents. Really nice.
Yeah.
This year was a really good year.
Yeah, the weather has helped, but I think that it has also gotten momentum, and it's just become, I think, the community event of the year, basically.
Yes, and Friday night was, I heard, the busiest day in 10 years.
I was told 10,000 people came through the gates on Friday night, which is definitely a record, and I think it's a testament to the fine restaurants that are here and the organization and the entertainment, and it's become an event that everyone looks forward to. Put it on your calendar for the first weekend of August every year.
And it didn't rain.
That's the key to it all. That's really the key. It didn't rain. Now, you're here, you're back, you've been doing it for 10 years. What are you doing this year? What are we serving?
Serving what I serve every year, a filet slider that everybody loves. The only, this year I didn't serve any corn on the cob because all the rain at Boley Farm, I buy all the corn from Boley Farm right here in Orland. I believe shopping local here.
Yeah.
And he grows his corn in Kankakee, and he couldn't grow it in June because we had 24 inches of rain.
Whoa.
So this year was not a year for corn. I could have bought it from somebody else, but I feel that Boley Farm's been with me for 10 years. I'm sticking with them.
You're sticking with them. So you'll have the corn and the cob will be back next year, but you wanted to keep the quality of everything you serve up to top, best in class.
Absolutely. That's important to me.
Okay, so that's what you are. I've always said, Brian Sword, best in class, 94 West. Whether you're here out at the Great Outdoors at Taste of Orland or you're at back at the restaurant. You want to talk a little bit about the restaurant and how will the taste be a springboard as you get back to the restaurant? What's coming up at the restaurant? Anything special in the next few months as we head to the holidays?
You know, every Friday and Saturday, pretty much, if you look at the website, we have some entertainment. I have a beautiful outdoor patio I don't think a lot of people know about. What a waterfall.
You got a waterfall out there?
Yes, I do.
Whoa.
When you came, it was in the wintertime.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, okay, so now that it's summer, I need to get out there, and we need to get that waterfall on film, and we need to get out there and enjoy it. So, folks, 94 West on 94th Avenue here in Orland Park, outdoor patio with a waterfall. You're not going to find that hardly anywhere, I think, in Orland Park.
And just to remind everybody in Orland, since I have that car wash up the street, I keep on hearing that people think that 94 West closed. I'm here talking to you, to Orland Park. Been there 12 years. Still going on after the 40 years my dad in business, and let people know we still got great steaks, seafood, and it's a great place to go to.
The finest steaks in the state of Illinois, definitely in Orland Park, but the finest steaks in the state of Illinois. You have brought the Downtown Steakhouse to Orland Park, and I've heard that many times from many people, and I continue to hear it. You've got a wide, diverse menu, and as you you're serving phenomenal stuff, phenomenal food here. Anything special like at the restaurant? If I'm gonna walk in, what is my go-to dish that I'm gonna order at 94 West?
A bone-in ribeye or a sea bass? Outstanding.
Bone-in ribeye or sea bass? So you get they're both healthy, but sea bass, of course. Supposed to eat more fish because they say fish is brain food. I don't eat a lot of fish, as you can tell, but
and we have a lot of fish specials. We have a great different variety of fish on the weekends. We get flown in every Friday and Saturday, and we have the specials on Friday and Saturday.
So you have fresh fish that's flown in each weekend.
Yes.
Remember that, folks. So we're all gonna go visit 94 West. We all look forward to it. Brian Sword, the proprietor, the driving force behind 94 West. We look forward referred to it. Oh, can you confirm this rumor that the Beatles are playing here tonight? The Beatles band, American English. Since Paul McCartney's in town, I heard a rumor that he's going to come by and sit in with them. Is there any truth to that rumor?
Yep, he's at the Peninsula. I'm going to pick him up in about a couple hours and bring him in.
Bring him in. Okay, so we got Paul McCartney here. You heard it here first, folks. Paul McCartney playing at the Taste of Orland Park. A rumor's running rampant, but it'd be fun to see him come by. Brian Sore is going to be picking him up later.
But believe this or not,
yes, sir.
He was at the restaurants Friday. Paul was at my son's restaurant downtown. So I really tried to get him here, and he said no.
Yeah, Paul McCartney was at the restaurant?
Yes, he was there on.
Okay, so
we get lucky. We're by the Peninsula. And pretty good. My son does good down there.
Yeah, so I'm sitting here. I must be seen by royalty because it is Sir Paul now, and you're down there, and now you've seen him. So
yes.
Very good.
Hey, one good thing. Please buy local. I live in Orland. The money stays in Orland. Go to Joe Rizza Ford, Joe Rizza Cadillac. This is where Dan's even from, if nobody knows that.
Yes. Yeah.
But
in case
you
don't.
He knows I support Orland, and it means a lot to a lot of local people to keep in Orland Park.
Yes.
And it's important.
It was an unsolicited commercial for Joe Rizza, but we encourage it. We encourage it. So, Brian, we want to thank you for allowing us to come by today, and we look forward to seeing you for many years, many days, many meals at 94 West. Mr. Brian Sword, thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thanks.
I'm Dan McMillan. We're here for Orland Park TV at the Taste of Orland Park. I'm Dan McMillan, and we're here back at the Taste of Orland Park, Orland Park's premier event. And we are in the booth for Orland's premier restaurant. And we're here with the proprietor the lady that runs the place, running it this weekend, and without her, that place over it's 157th and Harlem Avenue, Cooper's Hawk in Orland Park. Amy Okun, did I say that right?
Amy Okun, but you can
That's okay. Amy Okun. Amy, thanks for having us today.
I think we're happy you're here. We're happy to be a part of it again.
Yes. We're here at the Taste. Cooper's Hawk is one of the finest restaurants in Orland Park, if not the finest. Definitely the classiest. That's why they don't let me in, because they're so classy. But Amy, let's talk a little bit about the Taste. What does the Taste mean to Cooper's Hawk?
You know, it's a lot of community involvement. We have been in Orland Park this October. It'll be our 10-year anniversary.
10 years.
So it's really great to get out of the restaurant and be a part of the community and really just get to see people and change up the scene. You know, we had the owner, the president, founding member owner, Tim McHenry, was here yesterday on site. And he was actually here for his grammar school reunion with St. Michael's.
Whoa, very good.
Yeah, so good stuff.
So that shows you how much of Orland being such a fine community. He's here, having a wonderful community event this weekend with the Taste, and they're having a reunion at St. Michael's for an elementary school.
Yes, yeah, he was just out here, and he was very involved with the families and the town that he grew up in. He's very involved and very present, so it's great. We changed up the menu this year. So we changed up the wine. The sangria is always a given. It's always a huge hit. We have our house-made meatballs. We brought our egg rolls, which is our standard, and then we featured our chips and dip this year, which is great.
So it's flying off the shelves?
Yes. Meatballs and egg rolls are like neck and neck. So, so we really are just happy to be here. So thank you.
Now, are these items that we can get back at the restaurant also?
Yes, sir, always. So we would never come to the Taste with anything that's not featured in our restaurant. So we did do a little menu change. We wanted to feature that and just also reach out to some guests that maybe have never come to us yet.
Yes, so you want to get get out there. Yeah. People that don't know Cooper's Hawk, which it's hard to believe no one does know Cooper's Hawk, but it's a great restaurant. We love being here. We love the fact that you're here. What do we see as the taste being a springboard to the rest of the year? What do we have happening the rest of the year? We're going to talk a little bit. If you want to talk a little bit about the 10-year anniversary and what we got coming up through the holidays.
We do. We're always present at Orland Square Mall. So we're at Orland with our booth that will sell our gift cards. We're celebrating our 10-year anniversary with a very special party that Tim McHenry's hosting. And then we just really are celebrating our sister store in Oak Lawn. So that brings a lot of more maybe families that grew up in Orland and Oak Lawn and Burr Ridge. It really comes together as a community and a family. So it's great.
It's the 10-year anniversary and you're having a special party.
Yeah.
You think I might get an invitation to that? It's a community event, but if it doesn't happen, our invitation might get lost in the mail. That'll happen.
I'm sure Nicole or I will get you. We'll definitely get you in.
Okay. Is that Nicole Sletka?
Yes, Nicole and I, we're the sisters. They call us the sisters.
Sisters, and because of you two, you run this place. That without you, it would not run, and we would not have Cooper's Hawk. At least not Cooper's Hawk to the elevation that you guys have taken it.
Well, we definitely are. Still, our general manager Ryan Quisenberry and our area director Paula Morales very involved in Jason Plutz, who was one of the original general managers, still very involved in the community. And then Tim McHenry was here yesterday, so awesome, really awesome, because we have 19 locations now across the country.
Yes, you do. And you know who? And just a point of reference here, just a coincidence. My neighbor Jim Burke does the bathrooms, does all the plumbing at Cooper's Hawk. That was when they're building them. He's always putting them in. So just a point of. In case you ever get a trivia question, who does the bathrooms at Cooper's Hawk? Who put them all in? Burke Plumbing. Okay, so we want to.
I love it. Get that plug in. I love it. Yes. And a lot of our staff did grow up in Orland Park, went to School District 135 or District 234. Yeah. We have a lot of staff that's right in the neighborhood.
That is it. This is it. Buy local, stay in the community as best you can. And one of the best places in this community is Cooper's Hawk. Do we call it? Everybody just says Cooper's Hawk. What's the full name?
Cooper's Hawk Winery and Restaurant, 15690 South Harlem Avenue. In Orland Park. Not Tinley, Orland. We love Tinley, but we're in Orland Park.
Yes, you're in Orland Park at 15690, which used to be the address for Joe Rizzo Ford also. Yeah. And then we moved around the corner to 159th Street. But to summarize it all, what does the taste of Orland mean to you individually and Cooper's Hawk?
Definitely community. Family and community are huge within our concept, and food brings people together, and everyone likes to celebrate with a glass of wine.
Yes, it does. So, last question. We got the Beatles playing tonight. It's going to be wonderful out there. Beatles, I have to ask this question always at the end and get your thoughts. Beatles or Stones?
I'm not going to lie. I like the Rolling Stones. I'm high energy. My father likes the Beatles. I like a lot of high energy.
That's okay.
And we have great music at Cooper's Hawk.
Yeah, so you like the Stones, but you'll be jamming out to the Beatles tonight, which is okay. So
Bad English or?
American English will be here tonight. There was a rumor that Paul McCartney being in town might stop by and sing with him, but I don't think that's going to happen. So we're going to wrap it up here. We want to thank you very much for having us.
Thank you.
Dan McMillan here at the finest wet restaurant in Orland Park, Cooper's Hawk Winery. What am I calling it?
Cooper's Hawk Winery and Restaurant.
Cooper's Hawk Winery and Restaurant. Stop on over. We look forward to seeing you. It's my favorite. It's my favorite. As long as I get an invitation to that party for the 10th anniversary.
That's Paul and I will sneak you in.
I got to be snuck in. That's what it's come to, folks. Thank you very much. I'm Dan McMillan for Orland Park TV. Thank you. Part two. Folks, we're still here at the Cooper's Hawk Winery and Restaurant and here at Taste of Orland, and we just got some meatballs. One thing I forgot to say, one thing great about the community, this young lady here, Amy, was also a Pioneer cheerleader for 8 years and then went on to Sandberg. So what do you think of the Pioneers this year?
Well, I know they're going to Gatlinburg because Pioneers only produce winners. We only produce winners.
Yes, we do. So you've heard it here, folks. The Pioneers only produce winners. Amy has said it, so we want to thank you here from the Pioneer Land and at Cooper's Hawk Winery and Restaurant. Thank you, Orland Park. Park. I'm Dan McMillan, and we're back here for Orland Park TV here at the Taste of Orland Park, the premier event of the year here in the southwest suburbs. We've made our way over to what we think may be the front runner for the booth of the year. The results come out a little later, but we think Banana Bliss may be able to take the top spot. So what do you think, young man? Can you first introduce yourself to the camera?
I'm Tony from Blissful Banana Cafe.
Tony from Blissful Banana Cafe. I know, and it's a family affair. Is your mother, is she on her way?
She's around here somewhere.
Okay, we'll find her. So Cindy, who created the menu, she created it, and then you took it to the next level, and so you've made it what it is today. So you should get a lot more credit than you do get. Is that what I'm told?
You can say that. Yeah.
Okay, that's it. So we're here at the Taste of Orland. You guys have been here how many years?
This is our third year at the Taste of Orland.
Third year at Taste of Orland. You're over on, and a big part of being here at the Taste is to get exposure for the restaurant as well as have some fun and make a little money and just be part of one of the most enjoyable events of the year here in Orland Park. So what do you hope to take out of the Taste of Orland Park for Blissful Banana?
Just a lot more exposure to the community. Being able to be here every year is actually awesome. We love doing this, and we love all the other people that are here, all the other restaurants. We get along with them well. You know, we do the trading of the food. Instead of like our restaurant having to pay for food at another restaurant, we'll just swap out menu items.
Works out well. So it's good to see a part of the community, folks. Everyone gets along. Blissful Banana, we're here. It's your third year here. You're in the running to win best booth. What are we serving here this year at the Blissful Banana at Taste of Orland?
We got a Philly cheesesteak. We have our veggie hummus wrap. We have our southwest chicken wrap. We have our banana blisses. We have our gorilla coffee. And then we also have a thin mint Blissful blend.
Blissful blend. Now, the Philly cheesesteak's one of your specialties at the restaurant, is it not?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Okay, now, one of the significant parts of why it is significant and special at the restaurant, can you explain why Philly cheesesteak is so important to you guys?
Most of our family is from Philadelphia, so we wanted to nail down a Philly cheesesteak out here.
Yeah.
Because no other restaurants really have gotten that down around here.
They have not.
So we wanted to take that and bring it to our restaurant.
So you're from Philadelphia, so it's a real sense of pride that you serve the finest Philly cheesesteak in the state of Illinois.
Yeah, that's a big point of pride for us.
Yeah, it is. It's a big point of pride, and I do think it's the finest I've ever had. And so what I do look forward to is trying some of the many items you guys have back at the restaurant, because I think that it's really important. We talked about it when we did the show a few weeks ago on the road to the Taste, which has been running, and I've heard people tell me it constantly, who is that handsome young man that you were interviewing? So you'll probably get a lot of dates out of that show. But when you're talking about the restaurant itself and what you're doing, it's so important to get the word out, because so many people think Blissful Banana, it's a smoothie shop and things like that. So are you finding more people coming in and really knowing, you know, hearing about how wonderful your food is?
Yeah, we definitely have a more outreach in our community, especially through here, through the Taste of Orland. We'll hear, you know, people, where are you guys located? Never heard of you before. Yeah. Do you sell just smoothies? But no, we have a full menu. We have a bar. We have our whole liquor license. So you come in, you can get a beer, you can get a mixed drink, you can get a wine if you want.
You can get it all. You can get it all. Now, we did the show a few weeks ago, and I cooked. What did I cook? Wasn't it the bow tie pasta?
No. That was the shrimp risotto.
Shrimp risotto. And is that one of the signature dishes?
That's one of our specialties that we run maybe once a week. We'll run that. but we change our specials every day. So those are one of our special items that you can get, you know, once a week.
So you change the specials every day, so you have some standards, which I heard your burger is phenomenal, and Philly cheesesteak, of course, is always going to be there. But you got some of the specials, so give us an idea of some of the other specials that if we come in, that we may have a chance to enjoy.
We have our vegan sweet potato quinoa cakes, which everyone tends to love. It comes with an avocado dressing as well. And what else? We have our sweet potato pancakes as well. And then another one is our... I can't think of another one.
Oh, you got so many.
We do.
That shrimp risotto, of course, is the finest one with me cooking it. But those potato pancakes sound very good. They sound very good. So as the taste is going to wrap up today, we're here. It's on a Sunday, and we're going to have the Beatles playing tonight. And it's just been a wonderful event. What can you summarize? What does the taste come to mean for you individually and the Blissful Banana?
As far as the taste goes, just the taste, it's about our community coming together and learning about these restaurants that not everyone knows about, yes, and being able to sample some of the food that they're putting out.
Yes.
So that's like a big, big point of this thing for me and our restaurant.
Yes.
Just getting our name out there and for people to be able to know where we're at, yes, and what we're doing there.
Okay, so Blissful Banana, one of the finest restaurants in Orland Park on 94th Avenue. So, folks, let's make sure we get down there and enjoy all the... They've got so many good things, so many healthy items, non-healthy items, and they've got great burgers, a lot of gluten-free stuff. A lot of gluten-free?
Yep, we do. We specialize in a lot of allergies, peanuts, anything, gluten allergies. We specialize in that, make sure there's no cross-contamination or anything like that. So,
now,
allergies.
You have an allergy, you guys can, you're very aware. You're very accommodating of it. Now, let's get down to some real important business, though, also. You played football at Andrew High School, correct?
Yes, sir.
How is Andrew High School going to do this season, the 2015 season, high school football?
They're probably going to take it all this year. I'm very hopeful about it.
Will this be the year?
I bet it will be.
Okay. Andrew's going to have a huge year. Of course, Sandburg football will we look to go far in the playoffs this year. So we're here at the Blissful Banana. Tony, we just want to say we really love everything you guys do, and I look forward to visiting, but I'm looking for everyone in the audience that's watching now will be visiting the Blissful Banana within the next month, and they will be lifelong customers of the Blissful Banana. So thanks for having us today at the Taste of Orland Park. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm Dan McMillan for Orland Park TV. We want to thank the mayor of Orland Park, Dan McLaughlin, and the trustees for putting on another wonderful event, the Taste of Orland Park 2015. Thank you. Hello, Orland Park. I'm Dan McMillan, and want to thank you for being here today and being here at the joining us here at the Taste of Orland Park. It's been another wonderful event. We've been able to visit with so many fine restaurateurs and so many wonderful people out here today. This is the final day of the Taste of Orland Park 2015, but it's been a memorable experience. It's set a record. Friday night had over 10,000 people, and it's got so many good things happening today, and it'll culminate with American English playing tonight for the crowd. It's going to be a wonderful, wonderful event, one that everyone will have so many memories of, and look forward to next year, Taste of Orland 2016. But that wraps up our show for today. I hope everyone enjoyed it with all the restaurant tours that we were able to visit with here at the Taste of Orland Park. We want to thank Mayor McLaughlin and all the trustees for putting on another wonderful event, Taste of Orland 2015. I'm Dan McMillan, and thank you for watching.
Thank you. Good to be here on Channel 4. Thanks for having us.
A single one. Please, please, me. One.